sometimes a break needs to be taken because the taping process, the recording device stops on its own unless it's stopped by me. So that's about Bosnia. And I also mentioned briefly the Serbian and the case of the Bulgarians. But let's recall what happened in Serbia, or with Serbia. That, let's recall that Serbia existed as a state before the expansion of the Ottoman Empire. There's Serbia. And even it was the peak of its flourishing, it expanded and controlled other lands and so on. But then it fell. Now remember that the key moment here is the Battle of Kosovo, the Field of Blackbirds of 1389. This is the historical moment, the historical tragedy, the most tragic moment in Serbian history, at least up to recently. When it lost statehood, it disappeared. Right? Just like Poland was dissolved at the end of the 18th century, well, this is the similar event. Right? Not only did it disappear, but it was from a flourishing state, it became just a people of peasants, under the Ottoman Empire for several centuries. And notice that when you're a people of peasants, you're not allowed to develop culturally, politically, administratively, and so on. So what remains then, right? And this is why it's important. What remains? Well, what did these people have to maintain their Serbianness, or whatever that is, throughout history, if you don't have a political unit, and they didn't have their own dialect? So this is where that millet system was what I told you that was the way in which the Ottoman power treated the non-Muslim populations. That they were organized around their churches. Right? So the Serbian identity will be built on a few pillars. Serbian identity will be built on, one, the memory of loss. The popular memory of the Battle of the Field of Blackbirds of Kosovo, when we lost our state, when we lost ourselves, when we lost country, right? Now, this battle was a little bit more complicated, because actually in the battle you had Serbs fighting on each side, because that's, again, we read back into the past like it was Serbians against the Ottomans. Actually, no. It always happens that, just like, you know, the Ottomans had allies in all kinds of parts, and there were some Serbians who were allied with the Ottomans, as local rulers who wanted these guys to die, and these guys wanted those guys to die, and they were both Serbian and whatever. Some allied with the Ottomans, some not with the Ottomans, whatever. The point is that the result was the disappearance of the state of Serbia, for sure. And this is a historical tragedy. So memory of the Battle of Kosovo, memory of losing, but understand how important it is when you build your identity on a loss, right? Then the church, the Serbian Orthodox Church becomes the set of institutions that maintain coherent common identity. Remember that reality is shaped by institutions. Remember that these realities that call the state of Washington is actually a set of institutions. If you remove the institutions of government, there is no Washington. Okay? Let's understand. Because borders are imposed by institutions, sets of institutions. You know, police, military, whatever, postal service, whatever. They control and define borders. Now, the church was the institution that maintained, that was the backbone of this society as a society. And which one? The Serbian Orthodox Church. And then it was folk culture. Folk culture, songs, stories, remembrances, the way they dress, the way they behave, mostly peasant culture. Okay? And these will remain the essential backbones of Serbian identity, besides the language that they speak. Okay? The same will apply to the Bulgarians. The same will, remember, Bulgaria was a huge empire, one of the greatest empires in the world history, in the world, around the year 1000 and so on. But they fall to the Ottoman Empire. But again, there the same thing happens. It becomes a society of peasants. It becomes a society defined by, their church. From the beginning, remember that the Bulgarian state was defined and became a coherent society because of the Bulgarian Orthodox Church, which unified the Bulgarians and the Slavs, who were the original population, right, into one Bulgarian identity, Slavic speaking, but, mix of non-Slavs and Slavs. and, you know, folk traditions. And this will be common for many of these Slavic peoples of the south here, except for the Bosnians, which were, because there was no strong identity, because there was no strong church. Here you see the difference. There was not one Bosnian church. Remember, it was divided between three different, one Catholic, one Eastern Orthodox, and one neither. So division, there was no system of institutions to withstand this cultural, societal pressure of the Ottoman Empire. So it becomes assimilated into the Ottoman Empire with its own identity, but assimilated. It takes up this, you know, the Muslim identity and so on. So that's a short overview of course, this changes, things change by 1800. But remember that even in 1800, these lands will still be within the Ottoman Empire. So from Bosnia to the east, you will still have these lands in the Ottoman Empire, although with increasing grumblings and so on. The Ottoman Empire suffers severe decay in the 17th, 18th century. By the 19th century, it will be considered the sick man of Europe. It was very weakened, and it was also in crisis because it did not manage to reform itself. This is why you see these patches of people. These are local peoples rebelling against the Ottoman rule, and because economically, socially, politically, it was stagnating, corrupt, not developing, and so on. So this is, there are many groundings, but it's still, these are still under Ottoman rule, although now the influence of Russia towards the end of the 18th century will be much more important, and Russia will project its interest, interesting enough, around in this area of the southern Slavs. So not Romania, but not these people, but here in the area of the southern Slavs. Because Russia, the Empire of Russia, and I will end this on this note, will claim to have the right to defend the Christians of the Ottoman Empire, but those Christians were actually Slavic peoples. And in the name of Slavic identity, which was obviously a different identity, but they claimed the right to sort of speak into the internal affairs of the Ottoman Empire. This is important because it will be the beginning, in a way, of an ongoing intervention and interest of the Russians in the Balkans,